Where in God's name do you get "I'm too sexy for my shirt"?
Well, we did. We were in a studio in.
Cheers, by the way.
Cheers. Yes.
Very nice.
Cheers. 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 Well, I feel a bit like, you know, I should join in, but I fancied a Pinot. Anyway,
yeah,
in a basement studio, had a bass line running around on a loop for another song, which went da 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 da. And I could hear it, and it was getting really hot in the studio. So I went into the other room, and it was a guy's bedsit, basically. And he had a mirror cut into the wardrobe. And I could still hear this thing going da 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 da. And for some inexplicable reason, I took off my shirt and started going, "I'm too sexy for my..." And that's it. So,
and thus greatness was thrust upon you.
History was made. That was it. And Fred's a bit of a Dylan fan. So initially, Fred didn't get the gag.
I didn't quite get it,
I'll be honest. Yeah.
And then I had an American model. I was seeing this American girl, and she actually said to me when I met her, "I'm a model. Do you know what I mean?" She actually said it.
Yeah.
And I remember that. And Rob had this little guitar line. Da, 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 da. So the minute I thought we should put that to that, and then I got, okay, now I see it. Yeah. I understand it.
And actually, with the second song, which was "Don't Talk to Us, Kiss," yes, Fred's girlfriend said that to him as well.
Yes. Yeah. I don't give him a co-write.
We get all our lyrics off ex parties.
To this record.
Yes.
You know, and it's out there. And who was it? Because it's before the internet, it didn't exist.
Yeah.
So you kind of had to have a Radio 1 DJ play it. What was the way in which suddenly it took off?
It was thanks to Gary Crowley and Simon Bates at Radio 1.
Right,
they're exactly the two people that are responsible for the initial plays. Record companies wouldn't touch it. No one would touch it. So we said to her, we had this very young manager, Tamsin, who was great. And she said, "Look, why don't we just get it to radio and we'll take it from there." So that's what happened. Yeah. She got it to radio. And Simon Bates was kind enough to play it off the acetate, along with Gary Crowley played the 12-inch. And literally, the minute they played it, apparently the phones went insane at Radio 1. and we got back to our gym, because we had a gym shift, and we got back and the phones were going mad. There's all the tabloids were on the phone.
There's a very early clip where we were with Kid Jensen doing a show in the very early days, and we were we didn't have any stylist or anything, we just wore whatever we could find. And there's us performing "I'm Too Sexy," and if you look at the crowd, their faces, it's like, what's going on here?
Of course it went on, and you're on top of the pops, and you get to number one.
Number one in America.
Which I have to say was a pretty amazing thing to do.
We couldn't believe that.
That was odd.
We've talked about this before. And when you're in the middle of a storm, and you're right in the middle, you don't even know that it's happening.
No.
It's only when you view it from outside that you see
the madness
of it. Yeah. So at the time, we didn't really clock it, I don't think.
We just got on with it.
Yeah.
We just thought we're lucky.
Yeah.
And yet, it's endured.
This is the
extraordinary. There was a spinning image sketch last week of Rishi Sunak saying, "I'm too sexy for this job." I should be the PM. I mean, so it still goes on. And I understand that in America, you know, they use the music in adverts, so you're still earning royalties from it.
Yeah, Beyonce is using it at the moment. She's number one on her album in America.
Yeah. Yep.
Drake used it last year, and then Taylor Swift in 2017.
Swifty to you, actually.
Swifty to me, yeah. and so we'd be, that sort of thing's just luck. You don't know people are going to pick it up.
No.
That's impossible to know.
It's not going away.
No, it's not dying. No, it's not.
And people have said to me, "Have you ever got sick of performing it?"
Yeah.
And I can honestly say, hand on heart, never have.
No, it's good.
Not once.
Yeah.
You've made loads of other music.
Yes, we have.
You know, Deeply Dipping, and yet, you're never going to surpass.
I think it'd be...
I think it would be a tough call.
Yeah. I do. Yeah. I hate to say that, but I think sex has just become this little industry on its own.
Yeah.
Well, it's fantastic. Yeah. And you've done incredibly well out of it.
I'm proud of it. It's a very, very... It's just a fun thing to do.
Yes,
it's just, you brilliant. Know.